In an effort to keep up with the amazing changes in game development, Sony has made the PS4 Pro. Sony says it's the perfect console to get the most out of your 4K TV and your PSVR headset. Well, we here at iFixit like to judge things for ourselves, and there's only one way to do that. So, let's tear it down. The PS4 Pro is unsurprisingly much larger and heavier than Sony's last version of the PS4, the Slim, but getting into it is very similar. First out is the user-replaceable hard drive that is held in place by a single standard Phillips zero screw. While Sony boasted about the PS4 Pro's support of SATA 3, the stock hard drive we received is labeled at 3 gigabits a second, which is actually SATA 2 speed. We found some online sources reporting that this drive is actually a 6 gigabit a second drive, but at 5400 RPM, this platter drive will never reach SATA 3 speeds. The first panel removed reveals nothing much but the power supply. This thing dishes out a whopping 289 watts of power, up from the 165 watts in the 2013 version. Flipping the PS4 Pro over, we removed the second panel only to find a layer of shielding with a lot of screws holding it in place. Underneath, we find the motherboard. On the board, we see the 8-core Jaguar X8664 CPU, which also includes the AMD Radeon GPU. And on the other side of the board, 8 GB of Samsung-made GDDR5 RAM. You can find the complete list of chips we've identified at iFixit.com. After removing the large heat pipe assembly, we're only left with the optical drive and fan. The fan is rated for 2.1 amps at 12 volts, or 25.2 watts, explaining where some of the extra power supply power is going. Lastly, the optical drive came out featuring a lot of springs, a lens assembly on a track, and some sweet gears. We've come to the end of our teardown, and now we turn our thoughts towards repairability. How did the PS4 Pro score? It got an 8 out of 10, and here's why. On the upside, no adhesive makes disassembly and reassembly easy. The non-proprietary hard drive is simple to access and upgrade or replace, and doing so will not void your warranty. While you can freely clean the fan, removing it and other components requires a lot of warranty-voiding disassembly. And finally, on the downside, security screws and tamper-evident seals discourage users from disassembling and repairing their PS4. For the complete teardown, including tons of beautiful, high-quality images, head on over to iFixit.com. Don't forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel to stay up to date on all our latest teardowns and repair videos. You can follow us on Twitter at iFixit and give us a like on Facebook at facebook.com/iFixit.